This is Indie Book Publishing. Indie Book Publishing is a show about new books and the authors who wrote them. It's an opportunity for prospective readers to hear directly from the writers, to hear what inspired them to write and publish, and to hear all the inside details about their books. And now, Indie Book Publishing with your host, Steve Jorgensen.
The title of the book, Bridge of the Gods. The Golden Pathway to Your Highest God Self, a handbook for ascending humanity. And the author is Reverend Dr. Linda DeCoff. And Dr. Linda joins us now on Indie Book Publishing, this interview brought to you by Balboa Press. Hello, Dr. Linda.
Hello, Steve.
Well, great to have you with us. You're going to take us on quite a spiritual journey here, and we're looking forward to it. First of all, though, I'd like to read just a couple of things you've written about your book. You say your book, Bridge of the Gods, will really help you get over past destructive habits of mind and feelings that have led to disappointments and help you to really see yourself anew. The precious ray of God and the unlimited divine self that you truly are in God's eyes. Infinite horizons will open unto you. Well, we certainly, in this day and age, need to have unlimited and infinite horizons. There's so many people who do struggle, don't they?
Yes, and you know, what I have discovered is that we cannot change unless we go higher. You know, unless something changes in consciousness and awareness of oneself as who you really are, beyond your experiences, beyond the conditions you may be grappling with at the moment. Until persons get to understand who they really are as one with the universe, one with the unlimited, one with God and all that that means, you will not rise out of your circumstances. But it, once one has realized that, you know, we are more than meets the eye, we are far more, and there really are limitless horizons to which any individual can go, until we realize we're sort of going around in the same, some people call it karmic circles of cause and effect. So when we get a new idea of ourselves, beyond everything that we're living, even in the now, everything, awareness begins to change. And actually, new thoughts are inspired within your very spirit and soul, and within your mind. And you see yourself differently. And you know, through a certain process, it's very conscious. You know, they say the yogi must raise him or herself. So it takes the conscious participation by the individual in their own evolution. And according to, you know, how much you can perceive as possible for yourself, will as a universal spiritual individual, one with all that is, to the degree that you can see that about yourself, you can transform your conditions. You can come out of chronic, you know, so many people suffer and struggle with chronic conditions, and they try to address it mentally. They try to address it through willpower, through force, through even positive thinking, if it's not rooted in the very soul, in the very heart. You know, where you get the aha about something, you really see it, feel it, know it. You cannot, you just cannot, it's going to break down for you because it's held in place by mental force. So the process is at once a process of raising consciousness to be aware of the greater, and also of aligning the heart in a greater feelingness of unity with all that is. And, you know, it's the heart of the countless, many countless chambers that is evinced by all the great masters. And, you know, you wonder why, both in the East and the West, it's a common practice everywhere for people to meditate in front of a picture of the master, whoever that may be, whether it's Jesus, whether it's Buddha, even great personages. We study their lives and we read about them. And, you know, the very fact that we can recognize the greatness in these others who are demonstrating the higher qualities through their being and through their life and through their works means, if we can see it, it's because it's in us. You know, you can't see or recognize what is not in you. So, you know, tradition, we see that people honor the great saints, the mystics, and so on, is because we recognize something in them that is also in us. And through the observation of their lives and how they are and the virtues they manifest, and, you know, we can bring that unto ourselves because it is in us, but it needs the conscious cultivation.
Well, your life is filled with all kinds of different experiences. You're called the noted founder today of New Thought Institute of New York and New Thought International. But your life has been filled with an early career on Broadway and film, TV. You've even been a teen rock and roll singer. So, you
that's true. So I'm into self-expression.
Exactly.
And yeah, so it's been very varied, and I say that I have absolutely loved and been driven by love, you know, toward everything that I have done. So these, you know, these activities, which come from my particular, you know, creative self, the gifts that, you know, that God gave me, you know, opportunities just opened up in my life as I, you know, like Goethe says, just take one step toward whatever and the window of opportunity opens. So I learned to follow my heart and to follow whatever I felt compelled to do, and then the opportunity would open. So, yeah, I love music, and it started out with rock and roll singer at, you know, 13 years old, and we won all the competitions in the local area and, you know, awards, and had a wonderful time. And then it came to a point where that, you know, felt complete. And what came into my mind is that I wanted to, I was very attracted to performance because of the opportunity to go in depth into a character and then to deliver the character to the audience in such a way that the audience can develop a line of empathy. And as you know, in theater, you know, it represents life. So the characters that you're portraying are going to touch persons, you know, who may be going through a similar circumstance. And in all of art, there is a period of transformation where the character comes out right or, you know, something happens to change. And therefore, there is an opportunity to move persons, to share, you know, share through your performance what's going on with those other persons. And, you know, that also came to a point where I had, you know, really been honored to do great, great roles, you know, Nina and Chekhov, Seagull, and be on Broadway with Rex Harrison and do all these great and dynamic things. But still, you know, after doing some really, really, you know, very desirable, terrific, you know, roles, something was still compelling me. You know, and I used to say as a child, I want to be one of two things. I want to be an actress, or I want to be a research scientist, you know. Now, you know, that used to occur to me at 3 years old. Well, you know, where is that coming from? But the thing is that the depths of life and healing and the whys of why things are universality, you know, loving your neighbor, that's always been a big thing for me. I've always been universal in spirit. So I see all as one. And, you know, I became much more involved through a sequence of very extraordinary events, was brought in touch with great, great teachers. And, you know, when the student is ready, the teacher appears. So early on, I met some great teachers, healers, and so on. And then my depth of interest had to do really with healing, because I've seen a lot of situations in life with other people that I wish I could assist them. I felt that I could. And so these teachers, you know, through a combination of some very great individuals coming into my life, I began to formulate my own, you know, taking from what they taught me and putting it together as maybe, you know, another form. Not saying anything different, because truth never changes, but to express it in a different way, a very tangible way, a very immediate way to people, so that they could be empowered to change their lives.
Well, Dr. Linda, we have a few minutes left. I wanted to have you just, you know, expound a little bit more on this principle that you've mentioned now. You said there's no situation of a mental, physical, emotional, or spiritual nature that cannot be healed.
That's right. And so, you know, being that the human being is filled, the human soul, the human being, is filled with the divine. It's our origin, as I was saying before. So as you increase consciousness to know about yourself, what God or the universe or whatever word you want to use, the all in the all, the great isness, what is known about, as you increase yourself to embrace that knowing, you will rise up. So very practically, for instance, if you know there is a principle of perfect healing in the universe that people can use, you can heal yourself all the way, and many have, from the most, you know, what people call terminal conditions. People have risen above, because the great law, which is a law of your infinite being, supersedes any other lower law. And, of course, we've seen many do this, and many do not make it, but everyone who concentrates on the nature of the universe of God in you, of the all in the all in you, will realize there is no limit. So you can consciously practice in the midst of when you feel, I can't, it's impossible. You know, how can I? You say, well, it's not up to me, myself, as a little individual, but there is a power I can use that courses through me and all of life. And the more you say to yourself, I can, because of this power, I can use this power, and you consciously practice changing your hapless, negative, I can't thoughts to I can because of the infinite in me, not by your own will or power, but because of the infinite in you, you can. And you learn to draw upon this infinite resource through prayer, meditation, gratitude, you know, to immediately address whatever situation comes in front of you. So you're no longer thinking of yourself as alone in this universe, you know, dust to dust, a nothing, but you're recognizing there is the greater within you that you can use. And as I say, it must be conscious and applied right in the midst. And so the last thing, I know we're running out of time, but what I want people to know about this book is that it gives you, Bridge of the Gods is really the bridge the internal bridge to your highest conceivable self, you know, the rose and the seed, the absolute, the most developed you. And so as you, this book gives you not only information, but it gives you experience. So when you're reading it, and it opens with a it's a dynamic book. And so you open with a meditation that clears consciousness to be able to enter in to understand these things. There's lots of great stories of people who have worked the principle in tools people will find in this book, which are easy, and they're just interjected as we go along, up the ladder, so to speak. You address it, and you can have the change right then and there as you're reading, and you have the tools. So it's so important to have these very, very practical tools so that you can walk the talk. And the tools are there. The meditations are immense and soaring so that you can have the internal experience of yourself succeeding, getting over the chronics, getting past the limitations, getting there. And so when you can return, and it's this 12 chapters, they move the reader from the awakening, which helps, I hope, can help people to awaken to the truth of their pure self, and then takes you up the ladder to heal emotions, body, mind, so that you have this totality of spiritual healing as you go along. You become self-reliant, reliant upon the divine power in you and all surrounding. And it's a joyous adventure. It's not, you know, heavy and burdensome. And I believe God is near and dear. And I believe that every heart can touch this principle of the divine that is within and is a compelling force. Otherwise, no one would want to get well, you know, or even think they could. No one would want to do better in life. So the only people need to know the way,
Reaching and your divine capacity, as you put it.
Your divine capacity, it's in there. It can be brought out. There's a way. It doesn't have to be. You only have to desire. You only have to want this liberty for yourself. And, you know, liberty is not, you know, it's a practical thing. It will show up in your life. When you've made a change, your life will show you that. The mirror will change because what you're thinking into life and believing about life has changed. So your experience changing is an automatic. So I say work within.
Well, Dr. Linda, tell us how to get your book, Bridge of the Gods, The Golden Pathway to Your Highest God Self.
Yes. Well, now, Barnes & Noble, barnesandnoble.com, amazon.com, and balboapress.com have the book, and it's in hardcover, softcover, and also, you know, ebook for those who like to read, you know, read from their computers, and Kindle and Nookbook. So it's available in all versions. They also, if people would like to get a free preview of it, I most strongly suggest Amazon.com has right now, you know, the best free preview available. There's a feature called Look Inside. So if you go to, particularly in Amazon.com, if you go to the paperback or softcover version, rather than, you know, you may want to order the Kindle after, but if you want to see the best free preview, go into the book version, you know, the paperback or hardcover, and you'll get a good introduction, and you'll also be able to see on Amazon.com, the you know, 5-star reviews that have been coming in, and the benefit that other people are getting from it, and but it's available in all three bookstores, Barnes and Noble, and I think also Ingram has it, and various other publishers. So, but the main ones are Barnes and Noble, Amazon, and Balboa Press, who is my publisher. So, and they did a beautiful job. setting it up for me, and actually transporting the information to other sites so that people can purchase wherever they choose to. I was also, I don't know if it would be helpful, but to give, if people also want another, to look at the description of the 12 chapters, brief descriptions of, you know, what they will experience as they read the book. My author website has, you know, some very good, and blog has some very good information in there. So it's http://revdrlindadecoff.authorsexpress.com, and you'll find a lot of good information in there.
Reverend Dr. Linda DeCoff, thank you so much, Dr. Linda, for being with us on Indie Book Publishing, this interview brought to everyone by Balboa Press. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Steve. Have a wonderful day.